Hello and welcome to the Slightly Wilson Show. I'm your host, and today we're going to play some video games. So we're back on and all for another episode of the Slightly Scientific Starfield System Sprint, where today we are moving on to the next planet in our solar system, Neptune, and its moon Triton. That's where we're going. So come with me to my chatting channel. It is a fantastical Thursday. How is everyone today? I'm feeling a bit so-so. Ah! I think I slightly pushed myself a bit too much today, but it's all right. I managed to get through everything. We're back. We've upgraded the Nyan Cat again with more souls. This box is crushing into my leg, so I'm moving it. Yeah, good. It's this damn thing not being exactly the way I want it to be. Me having a sit at a weird angle on my desk. I think that's partly it. Yeah. Does anyone have any interesting news today then, for Thursday today? Anyone have any interesting news? I've seen that Lords of the Fallen is out now. People have started playing that. Not surprising, because it looked like it was going to be pretty good, basically. Yeah. Other than that, I can't really think of anything else that's jumped out at me. Sony have started doing movies. If you're a top-tier PlayStation Plus subscriber, you now get movies. I mean, I don't know who's going to care. But then again, it's nice to get something in that tier again that's not just, you know, old games that nobody plays anymore. That's all that's in there otherwise. Right, I'm going to go to the main channel. We're gonna play the game. Oh, it's not working. Is it working today, the game? Clicked on the game. It's not. Well, I got the right channel up. Show PC game. Game channel. Yeah. Seems to have gone wonky. It's not there. Let me click back on the game again. Set course to Neptune. Yes. That's where we're going. The game's decided today to not come across. Let me check in PC game layer again. It's got Starfield selected. Only Starfield. I'm clicking on the game. The game's playing. The game's running. It should go across. I guess it's the one thing I haven't, like, looked at today. It's working because I can hear it. You can hear it, can't you? You can hear it. There's stuff going on. And yet, for some reason, it's decided it doesn't want to be... It doesn't want to be captured. What are you doing? Let me try switching to something else. Capture any full screen application. Though, unfortunately, I don't think that... Oh, it does work with the game. Oh, okay. I didn't think that worked, but all right, full screen application. That seems to do it. Okay, it's fine. We've got it. We've got it, guys. Whee! Well, I'm going to turn the Mario Galaxy music off. Although the Mario Galaxy music works kind of well, in a way. It's space music. Well, there were three ships. Was one of them already destroyed? Though, hang on.
Judgment. Concentrate fire.
I can't remember which is which, so I'll just have to shoot this one.
Yes.
Varun Him. Let's try and get closer to this one as well. Boost. Use the boost to get through.
Target's grab drive is down.
Oh, I didn't get the kill.
So sorry, folks.
How's Varun clear this sector? Thanks for the help. Got pretty exciting back there.
Thank you for the help.
We're never gonna last long against the UC Navy. But we certainly didn't mind the support. Any way we can repay you?
You can give me some... Weirdly, repair parts. I don't know how many I've got.
You take care.
I can't remember the last time I... Oh, damn it. What's happened with my shield? Again. I honestly do not understand why the shield suddenly always empties itself. Yeah. Very weird, that. Very weird. Well, this is the Varun hymn. And we'll take those resources. Go after the other ones as well. Alrighty. Now, I've switched it back to the game music today. I don't know. If it gets boring, we could always swap it out. I'm gonna start trying to collect resources from the from these things as well. Well, you've made a request, Veos, for John Williams' Jewel of the Fates. I don't know this song, but yes, okay, right, we'll have a look. So, let's go to the karaoke channel. Veos has requested a song. So welcome! Click this again here. Yeah, there we go. Welcome, one and all, to Slightly Mad Cover. I never fixed the logo. It broke when I deleted one of my old plugins. And it's still sort of off the edge because I never fixed it. One day I'll get around to it. Welcome, one and all, to Slightly Mad Cover Songs. An entertainment night where you and your friends are out singing karaoke. When you request a song, instead of the words appearing on the screen, a small man appears instead to sing the lyrics to you in a very strange manner. So I must, yes, attempt to sing the song as requested by Veos, John Williams, Jewel of Fates. I don't know if I have heard this song before. That doesn't matter. I must attempt to sing it anyway. And afterwards, we will compare it to the real song and see how close I was. So, we'll have a look. General Jewel of Fates. From the Phantom Menace. Okay. Apparently, it's not very long. I don't know if I know what the language looks like, though. Is it because it's, like, Star Wars lyrics, so they therefore just, like, weird? Probably. Okay, this is my attempt, guys. This is our attempt at Jewel of Fates by John Williams. I don't even know how to pronounce these. Kora Mata Kora Ratama. Kora Ratama Yuda Kora Kora Sateo Ratamandanya Kora Kila Danya Ninya Kila Kora Ratamaf. Imagine it's something like that. So sort of massive things. Based on Celtic. Well, then I wouldn't get it, would I? Kora Diana Kora Matara Kora Diana Kora Matara. Noha Kila Kora Ratama Seato Kila Kora Ratama Kora Kora Matara Kora Ratama Korandenya Kora Ratama Niho Kila Kora Ratama Sede Kilo Kora Ratama Kora. That was rather fascinating. Let's have a look. Can I find an excerpt? Oh, is that one? Where it's like... it's like singing in the background. Oh, yes, it's more like, not epic enough. Well, I didn't know how they were pronouncing the songs, the lyrics. Yeah, they were singing it more long-winded, weren't they? So, let's just pull them back up. So it'd be more like, Kora Mata! Kora Tama! So it would have been like that, probably. But I wouldn't have guessed that that was, like, the tempo for the lyrics, based on just the lyrics themselves. Oh, well, there you go, Veos. Thank you for the... Thanks for the slightly bad karaoke request. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you did. Yes. Now we're gonna proceed back to Starfield, where we are currently in orbit. Currently in orbit of Neptune, and I am checking these rocks. See if there's anything interesting in these rocks. I found water and iron. I've never found water and iron in the same place before. That's weird. What's the cause of that? So what the hell is this? Mora's ship. Oh, wait. Is that the one that we took out at one point? Does it just stay here? Like completely disabled all the time now? I seem to like remember at one point we took it out. Oh crap, I bumped into it. Oh, I can't dock with it or hail it or anything. Weird. Does it just sit there now, completely dead in the water? That's very odd, that is. Don't know why that would be. Oh well, matters not. Let's have another look around. So we found water and iron. Never found iron palladium. Iron palladium. We found iron and palladium sometimes. Still surprised though. Iron. Iron, water, palladium. It's a very different composition, these asteroids, then, to ones we've found previously. We'll smash them, we'll head over and we'll have another look. Just remembering those. Water, iron, palladium. Now we've found iron. Lots of iron. Iron. Well, these asteroids are a lot further away than they appear. Iron. That's all I'm getting so far. I don't seem to be finding anything else. Iron. I'm getting a little bored of this, actually. What's with all this crap? It's just, well, crap. Might give up in a sec if it just keeps being iron, because I don't really understand why we're just getting iron. Nothing else. So where did the... Is that the moon over there? Oh yeah, there's Neptune. It looks surprisingly far away compared to some of the ones we've revisited. Hiya! You know, cheating by trying to translate. Well, I mean, if I tried to translate those songs, those lyrics, I don't think it would have made much difference. Yeah, I don't think that would have made any difference. I probably would have made it. It would have sounded even worse, Veos. You had yourself an interesting Thursday. Go on, mineral deposit. Get the mineral deposit. Oh, go on. It's right there. It's right there, bad boy. Water. So this is what I mean. This is very weird. Oh, I forgot when the middle one was we found again. Now, damn it. Iron, water. And was there tetrafluorides or something? Never found asteroids of iron and water before. Oh, this one's got gold, iron, and palladium. Gold, iron, and palladium. I can't remember from our previous spreadsheet catalogue of places that we've ever found anything like this. This is very different. We found ones before with iron, palladium, gold, nickel. But never water as well. It's weird that. Well, I'm gonna stick that down though. Stick that in my notes. Iron, iridium, palladium, gold. We haven't seen no nickel. We haven't seen any iridium. We've also, as I said, we've also somehow found water, which is strange. And we could assume that the others, hang on, I hadn't switched back to the chat. There we go. I don't know if we haven't found any nickel per se, but I guess we could just assume that we're going to find some anyway. Hi, Ian. Damn it. Again, that was a lot further away than it appeared. End up wasting time doing it. Iron. Nickel. Okay, now it's got nickel and all. So maybe it's just like that normal version where we normally find like a lot, but then I'm also picking up water additionally this time. Yeah, there's palladium. Not seeing any iridium or anything. Oh, the little asteroids that were following me around suddenly vanished. Don't understand how that happens. Let's just put these last three. These are the last ones. I'm not going to waste time doing it otherwise. Iron. 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 Yeah, no. That's it. It's all right. It's all right. Well, I'm going to get a picture of Neptune, because I don't have one. I don't have one at all. So we're going to open that. Press O in space mode to do photo mode. There's a... What is that over there? Is that all the way near Neptune? I wonder why. I've not seen anything like that before. I was trying to rotate, but I suddenly realised I don't know how to rotate. It's fine. We're quite far away, so unfortunately it just looks like a big black circle. The sun's behind it as well. But it is what it is. So we'll open our map and we'll have a little scan of Neptune. Not that we can learn too much. We've already got all the data we need. It's very cold. It's slightly heavier than Earth. It's got lots of helium and hydrogen. That's about it. Yeah. And then we'll here we go. Then we'll head over to set course X. Travel X. Triton, the moon of Neptune, which is the place where we can actually land. So we can't land on Neptune itself. I won't increase the surveying because that won't go up with the moon. Oh, and all I found here is debris. All right. Just got debris. Oh no, look, there's my little asteroids again following me around. Doesn't take long for them to come back, eh? Maybe it just depends the angle at which I'm going as to whether or not they're visible. Yeah. All right. We can see, just saw Neptune's all the way over there. Hang on, where'd it go? I did just spot it, now I can't see it. Oh, there it is. So Neptune's there, so turn around to the planet. To the moon, even. Moon. And it's on... It's on this side, the light on the left. So I'm going to remember that. Right. Do another photo I have not achieved. That's all I need. Perfect. Okay. Save picture. Nice. Right. And then we'll head down there. Oh. Yes. That's the You have to press so many more buttons, which is interesting when you're on PC. So many more buttons you need to press compared to normal. But I was just updating that, but we can see it's all frozen mountains. All frozen mountains. We're going to land, yes, we're going to land roughly here, I think. Frozen mountains. Right, land. So I will quickly make a notation of that. On the spready sheet, frozen mountains in there. Frozen mount. Oh, misspelled it. Mountains.
Landing site is sufficient. Taking the ship down.
I didn't get rid of the spreadsheet again. I might need to put the spreadsheet back over on this side. It was easier when it was on my other screen. I think. Can't remember off the top of my head. Right. We'll head out.
No indigenous life signs. One less thing to worry about, I suppose.
We'll have a look round. Can we see Neptune as I hoped from the angle I selected? Seems I could have been wrong this time. I don't always get it. It's not an exact science after all, because it's very tricky to get to know exactly what angle you're looking at the moon from when you go to land on it. It seems we need to find three resources, three mineral deposits. Ore deposits. We can collect. Ah! There goes. Seems we've already found two, one of which is water. So we'll get the ice. We'll get the ice one first. I always get annoyed that it's a different button. I don't understand why, but it's a different button to go into photo mode when you're on the ground. On keyboard and mouse compared to PC, I mean. Oh, what's happened to me Spotify button? Is it broke? I didn't like need it right now, but it suddenly. Oh no, it's back. Okay. Sometimes it disappears. Yeah, it is. It is playing. It is working. Okay. Sometimes it just stops working, and I haven't the foggiest idea why. Right, I'm gonna add the field note. Make field note. We'll get the stuff in the background in because it looks nice that way. And then why did that automatically open this again? I don't understand what it's doing with the browser. I'm trying to click on Madame. Yes, there it is. My water input device. There you go. We're not on Oberon, we're now on Triton. Triton. I think I've spelt that right. I guess we'll have to figure out. 1 second. Okay, take a field note and save it. Yeah. I'll just write that down. Triton. T-R-I-T-O-N is what I guessed. What does it say in the game? Hang on. I'm on the game. Oh wait, I'm still in map mode. That might be why it's not working. Yeah, I might actually switch the. I like having music on, so I might actually switch the music back to what we were doing yesterday, listening to some of the jazz and stuff like that. I couldn't really think of anything else that would work well other than the jazz. The jazz has been quite good, so. So that's a tad loud. So let's try putting it there. I should do it. If I'm right. Yeah. All right, good. Right, we'll take our field sample of the water. And then we're going to get some of this cobalt here as well. So let's add a object for scale. Used a chisel last time. Where's my... I lost the last one, but I did go back and get... Here we go, another tape measure. Drop R. Hey, there it is. Oh, it's... it's landed on it anyway. Lucky. Right, V. T to get rid of that. The shadow's kind of in the way. It's all right. I think, yeah, that'll work. It gets rid of it. Field notes. Make new field notes for a mineral. And it is cobalt. I spelt that right? I guess we'll know in a second. No, it didn't. It's not done it correctly. Let's have a look back in the game. C-O-B-A-L-T. I've like completely misspelled it. Dyslexia strikes again. C-O-B-A-L-T. Cobalt. Triton. And cobalt is a... Oh, no, it's uncommon. Uncommon. Uncommon ore. I should probably check that more, because sometimes I assume and then I end up making a mistake. So, there we go. Oh, yeah, don't want the shadow in there again. Everything else is fine. Good. Save. Yeah, it's done it. It's done it. Hooray! Nice one. What a night. People dancing in slow motion. Blurry. People dancing, really? Oh! Ha! I just twigged. I forgot to turn my HUD back on. Yeah, now I can see. Okay, let's collect some cobalt. So we're just missing some... There we go, nickel, apparently. There's nickel on the planet.
Apparently, when freezing to death, one may experience a warm, cozy feeling. I would prefer not to verify that firsthand.
I like that they have really interesting things to say when they're cold. Like, it's quite random, but it seems to just always be the case. Oh dear. Alright, I can see that it's minus 210. I wonder if that's it. I wonder if it caps out there, that like they don't do anything under 210. I don't know why that would be the case, but that does so far has seemed to be the case. What have I done here? I've messed up my spreadsheet. No, I think that's it. That's good. Yeah, on Triton, and then there we go, and then got the other ones, and then that will be 30. We'll have surveyed 30 places in the Sol system. No wonder it's taken a month from the game's release. Yeah, that's why I'm going to have to change it up, because otherwise I'm going to drive myself. It's been fun doing it this month, however. I think in the long run it's going to like half kill me, so I can't keep doing it this way. We're looking for nickel then. We'll also search, should we say, that location. It's the closest. We might find some more stuff over there. Is that nickel? Ooh, it is. We found some nickel, baby. Nickel. Right, get me inventory open. Miscellaneous, we will put, we got the mug. Where's me mug? Oh, my mug, Nova Galactic coffee mug. Drop, ah. Don't take a picture of it. Don't turn on your torch. I wanted you to just pick it up. The kicker is now that it's not going to probably want to sit. I'm going to try, though. No! It's frustrating because it looked like it was going to land correctly. Oh, it fell over. That'll do. That'll do, donkey. That'll do. I'm getting better at doing these controls. They're still a bit of a pain. Starfield, field note for a mineral. This is that we've found some nickel. Nickel. But I feel like I'm probably a bit better at spelling. Yeah, I am. I know how to spell nickel. Common or... There you go. Here. Nice. Okay. Save. That's a good one. Collect. Mug. Rock samples of the nickel. Which means we have now fully surveyed this moon and gained another level. In which case. Now got to 57. 57 planets. The heck is going on with the... Why am I now walking super slowly? What have I done? character's now walking instead of running. I'm not over encumbered. But he's decided to start walking. Is there a rule that controls how fast you walk? Eh, have I managed that? I mean, I can still sprint. When I'm not sprinting, I now walk. How, is there like some sort of keybind that I'm not familiar with? Oh, wait, hang on. No, no. Is there a keybind that I'm not familiar with? Sneak, hold to run, always run, auto move, quick keys, pause, escape, quick powers. There's all the space flight ones. Pair is O. It's useful to know, actually. Docked grounded, menu navigation, UI action. Those are. Rotate model, mouse 2, zoom in and out, quick container, outpost terminals, photo mode, blah, 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 blah. Why is my character now walking? I can't see it. I don't literally see anything. Well, no binding conflicts. Oh, I can drag. Thought I couldn't do that. There's nothing there, is there? There's nothing there. In which case, why? How have I managed to do this? Toggle always went. Oh, caps lock is toggle. Oh, oh, okay. You hit caps. It switches between permanently running or permanently walking. Oh, that's cool. I didn't know that was a thing. Yeah, I didn't know that was a thing, but that's pretty awesome to find that out, actually. Right, and there's the thing we were heading towards. It could be quite useful. Certain things, actually, having that there. Have you bound jump boost to a second key yet? Do I need to? I mean, it's on spacebar. I don't see why I'd need to have it on anything other than spacebar. I mean, I can't remember. Well, on controller, it's just Y, isn't it? Yeah. Can't sprint while in the air. You have to land before you can sprint. Yeah. I think we have made it to wherever the hell this is. A deserted robotics lab. We found one of these before? I think we might have. Yeah. We have. We found one of these before. And that button will boost you forward in the air. Like that, with the boost pack. Yeah, so it's just spacebar. It's just spacebar. I don't want to use this. Let's switch to Beowulf.
Smart.
Hello, pirate. Hello, robot. Boom. Oh, the robot didn't get damaged in like this. Oh, that didn't explode. That's why. Yeah, it didn't get exploded whatsoever. Take these out and get some bonuses. Oh. Even though I shot the robot load, I didn't get any XP
You're
for it.
Not walking out of here.
I didn't get any XP for that one either. Am I too high level now? Over there.
Where have they gone?
That one gave me XP.
You
thought you could evade me.
I'm on fire! Wilson is on fire! Pirate! Pirate, beware! One up and over. Thinking maybe I'd accidentally hit caps again. I haven't. Going to be used for exploration or going to points of interest. Yeah, being able to boost. Yeah, exactly. Where is Shazbo? Are these guys gone? Have they legged it? Hello? Oh, there you are. Crap, I have, because there's mines. Back away from the mines. Gotcha, lass. Mwah! Ha ha ha! And she's down.
Always worth checking. Never know what you might find in their pockets.
Take what we need and leave. That's what we'll do. Now see, we've been in the robotics lab before, so I can't be bothered to go inside it. I just wanted to clear out the outside so we got the resources. But yeah, I can't, the XP even. I can't be bothered to go inside. It's not really worth exploring it. That's the problem with the procedure generation. After a while, you've been to all these different places, so it's just, you just don't feel the need to go inside. Like, you might find a piece of better gear, but it's not really worth it at this point in time. So I'm better off going back to quests. And I think that's the part that people have been upset about, is this game really doesn't, don't think you read everything. Binding it to a second key boosts more forward than up? Really? How does that make sense? Settings. Bindings. What do you bind it to? Is it boost or just jump? It must be just jump, because there doesn't seem to be a second one other than jump. You used alt. Yeah, no, but I mean, like, what would I make the second button? Oh, you used alt. Oh, yeah, there we go. I'll put it on left alt. Let's see what happens. Got jump. That's the normal boost. And that's the alt boost. I think it is slightly more forward. That's weird though. Why would it do that? Why would it work differently depending on what button you're using? That's so weird. Hidden feature. Why, if I put them both on spacebar, would it do forward and up at the same time? Bindings. I don't know if that will work, but try. Space. Oh, it's not letting me... Space. Oh, it's just switching between the two. Oh, yeah, you can't have it on both. But it feels like maybe just put the normal space bar on the alt button then. Oh, no. Space bar's still just up, but alt... still slightly more forward. That's weird. Like, it's specifically, it's an actual feature last time this was the jump pack, not a bug. Why doesn't it say that anywhere then? Why does the game not indicate that that's a thing? I don't know which alt to use now then. I'll use the right. Oh, this is control. Well, that's the button. That's the right alt, one that's like next to it. The other one's like underneath my hand. Well, I mean, I don't know which is. No, actually, that one is easier to reach. One on the left. Well, pop back in. I'm stuck. I can't get in my ship. Come on. Yeah, there we go. There we go.
Always a satisfying moment.
And I'll actually, we'll drop the stuff with the resources we've been collecting into the ship, because I don't need to be carrying it around. Yeah. And we're going to continue our mission. So the mission we were on was provided loyalties. It's sitting like I've got... Oh yeah, to give a chlorine and stuff. Suddenly feel like I have a lot more in here than I remember. Travel to the den.
Run to your ship.
So we'll do that. That's it then. That's Neptune and Triton done.
Try. Time to join the stars.
And I'm thinking just because it will be easier to just blast through them, and tomorrow we'll smash out Pluto and Charon. And they'll be, and then we'll have Sol system finished. And there's more enemies again. Hang on, I just flew past them. Yeah, I was closer to them than I realised. Find it.
Fire! Fire!
Target ship's engine seems to be having trouble. Too bad. Target's grab drive is offline.
Now, I seem to be having trouble. Right, next one's above us. There it is. Ooh, ooh. Circle round. Asteroids everywhere here.
Take them out!
Go on, space tank. Take them out, yes. So yeah, we've managed to find more asteroids here. So it does sort of, it feels to me like it does seem... Ow, 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 asteroids are in the way. It does seem like the procedural generation means that we don't get it. You're trying to kill them or wine and dine them. Why do you think that, Veos? I've caught up. There we go. We've caught up now.
There goes their engine. They lost their shields. Tragic.
I think that's it. We've cleared them all.
Forces removed from this sector. I almost feel bad blowing those mercs out of the sky. Almost.
Almost.
You clean them up like you've done this before. Anyway,
this is not stage battle music. Oh yeah, you're right. Yeah, it's not. It's chill jazz music. Well, I mean, it is space battle music if you've seen Cowboy Bebop. Although, admittedly, they usually used punchier jazz music when it was space fights. Extra repair parts.
Thanks again.
I don't know if I do need extra repair parts, but I'm gonna collect them. Collect them, and then we'll see what we've got. Oh, the UC ship got destroyed as well. Now, it is making it sort of frustrating in regards to collecting data on the asteroids, on these asteroid fields around planets, because it almost feels like they are just randomized, in which case it won't matter collecting data about one. If when you come back, or somebody else goes to the same planet and they don't find asteroids with those materials in them, those minerals. Let's get a bit closer to this one. Actually, yeah, let's get the engines to full. Often do that, but it's taking too long to fly everywhere otherwise. Come on. Come on. Is this mineral deposit moving? I mean, while we go collect all the other bits, then yeah, I'll smash some of these asteroids and we'll have a look. Kaboom, baby! What have we got in this one? Iron. Do you think it's going to be very similar makeup to the same stuff as around Neptune? I mean, I don't know for sure. This is my point, that I might end up finding that the resources are the same if you find them, but only if, kind of thing. Like, if you don't find anything, you wouldn't get anything, obviously. But if you do find some, it would have the same stuff in it every time, depending on, again, the planet you're around or moon. That's what I'm interested in finding out. I've been trying to collect as much data as we can, but it's not been easy. This one's just giving me iron. Iron, iron, and more iron. There's another stiletto over there. Iron. Like, I find it hard to believe it's only iron, but there's nothing else around. Iron. Where else haven't we grabbed resources? Over there. Iron, nickel. Okay. Well, if it's got nickel, it's highly likely that it is the same stuff we've seen before. But we're not getting water. This one there, palladium. Something to my right. Is it nearby or not? Yeah, it is. Full speed ahead, Captain! That's closer. Grab that one. And the ecliptic stiletto. Come on, Robus there.
Yeah.
Veos is lurking. No worries, Veos. We will catch you later. Catch you later. More iron. Still quite far away. That one's quite far away. It's interesting how far away all these this debris from the space fight ended up. But then again, I guess it could all end up flying the same direction from when it got destroyed. Iron. No waters. None whatsoever. So. Yeah, look, this one is moving. I go in a straight line, it's moving away. There's one left. Flipping hell, it's miles away. But it's alright, I'm going to go on the basis that this is the same stuff as we'd normally found, but I'm going to remove the water, not include the water, because we haven't found any this time. So I'm going to go with that it's the iron, palladium, nickel, gold area type stuff that we've seen around other ones. I mean, it can take a while to find gold when you are searching these ones. Well, that's just a mineral deposit. It's not like it's a ship. Well, I'll still go over there. Screw it. But don't shoot on that. I want you to shoot other things. Oh, while it's locked on, you can't shoot any other direction. Now I can. Now there's an asteroid in the way. More iron in it. Iron. More iron. Yeah, that's it. I'm going on that basis. I'm not going to cook around spitting out trying to figure it out. Okay, now we'll go do this mission. Oh, wait, now, before we do, there are two things that we've technically skipped. It never occurred to me to go back and do. One is that we actually got another location. Yeah, we did. Oh, look, as if the other landmark I visited before is right next to there, which is to visit the London landmark. Well, I've done that. Did it not complete when I visited? I thought we flipping went there and it did it. Is it still in my missions log? Was it L? Activity. It's probably under here. Is it the London landmark? I thought we'd done that, technically. Did I not walk up to it? Is that what I did wrong? I'll walk up to it and then it might complete. Right here. I'm exactly where it wants me to go, and yet it's not got rid of the mark. Not rid of the. Oh, there's an actual thing here. Oh, I had no idea. There's a London snow globe. Oh, right. Yeah, we failed that then. Let's have a look at it. Oh, it's not visible. What? What's wrong with it? Is it broke? Well, even if it's broke, I found it. So we've done that one. And then there was another one. Map, there it is. Hong Kong landmark. Travel. Which is good because it looks like it's on the day side. Oh, is it just like the London one? But it's a big. Is that the moon up there? Nice. Probably is. But it's a Hong Kong skyscraper this time. All these landmarks are going to be basically like the tallest places on Earth. You have the London shard, and now we got, I guess, a big one in Hong Kong, but I don't recognise it personally. Yeah, no idea. Well, I mean, I guess if it wants me to come here again, there probably is another snow globe in a similar place. Do I have a mission for that too? Visit the Hong Kong landmark. Yeah, it is. Where exactly? I haven't foggiest. Ah, there it is. So it's another one. Maybe we can look at it a little better this time before I pick it up. Because for some reason they're not working in the inventory. Not too much. You can't actually make them snow, but it is. It's look. It's got the. It's got the. Right in the center, they've got the snow. The skyscraper itself. So that's what it's meant to be. These are nice little tidbits, but there's not much. Not much world building from these landmarks or places that we visit. Yeah. Interesting. Right, then we're going to back off. And then the last thing we're going to do is we're going to click on the Nova Galactic Starlight. Because I don't think I've ever actually gone there. Or have I just clicked on Luna rather than the Star Yard? Oh, no, there it is. There it is. Right, it's caught me jets. Fuck on. Because it's, I gather it had gone out of business, but it was the one, when we did the moon, it was the one thing we didn't actually go visit. Moon's moving well fast, this screen. Dock is R. Yeah, there we go. So I don't actually know anything about this location.
Ship is now docked.
But I don't think we've, I don't think we've explored it. Normally, as such. No, I don't think we've been around here. So it'll be interesting to find out what's going on at this location. Maybe there's a way to unlock new space parts, ship parts. Even if the place is abandoned, we can pick up blueprints or something. Door locked. Reminder, Infinity. Is it in, did Infinity LTD, who we just took down, did they take them down? No matter, no matter. Trying to use my eyes, but I have failed to discover what the solution is. For now, anyway. Next layer. I like using the spread ones. Then I don't have a 2 to go in there, so that fails. Let's try a 3 instead then. 3 and a 2. Done. Let's put that away. I've not seen any evidence there's enemies in here. Hello? Anyone here? I'm just wee Captain Wilson, settler comfort wear. Have I found that before? Sure. Notepads and more. Ammo galore. Is my torch like a lot darker than normal? Like sometimes it's dark, but right now it's like really dark. Nova Galactic Star Yard, so it's a separate area. I open this door. Oh no, we have been here. For the story. Are there going to be a bunch of enemies all shooting at each other? Yeah, there they are. Yeah, they do. They just can't keep coming back. That's why I keep getting confused as to whether there's anyone here or not. Because every single time I come back, they're all just back. I mean, it's free XP. So I shouldn't really, like, you know, turn my nose down at just killing these dudes. Ow. I'm getting shot in the ass. Ow. Hey, I forgot. I don't know what melee is on here, actually. What is melee? It's not Z. It's not X. It's not C. Is it T? No. G? No. Y? No. V? Oh, it's V! Ah, it's V! It took a while to figure out. Surprisingly. I'm literally here to do nothing except kill these guys, because I can't be bothered to do anything else here. Because it's just the same place we've already been. We've already been here. We've already fully explored and nicked everything. I don't know why it's just... I've done this like multiple times now. I've come back here thinking, surely there's something here that I haven't explored, but it's because of the fact that I keep forgetting that it's story related and that's it. It's like nothing else here. Ow! Who's that? Oh, you. Sorry. Oh, that's heal. Still more. Heal.
Get a bed back here.
Moving. I mean, we could switch it to maybe some more bouncier jazz for these sorts of fights. That would have been funny, wouldn't it? Wonder if I have some bouncier jazz. Da, 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 da. Let's try this one. It's not exactly. Is there any here that's sort of it's a bit more bouncy? Elegant, laid back, relaxing. Smooth, traditional, busy and frantic. It's a bit better. Not by much, but a bit. Best, I mean, that guy's got three pistols on him. That's very weird. What, how has that happened? Where are you? Melee! Say incomplete. Incomplete what? Incomplete jerk? Because that's what you are. You're an incomplete jerk. Oh. I meant to just take that. I don't know why I didn't take it. Just because. Yeah. No matter. Right! That was a really crappy detour, because there literally is no reason to be here. I wasted time coming back here. This is why I've been trying to catalogue everywhere we go, but then the same topic. Right, exit. Oh, now when I catalogued it on my spreadsheet, did I put down that it actually has the Nova Galactic Star Yard is in orbit? Oh, I did. Okay. Yeah, Deimos Star Yard, Nova Galactic Star Yard. Yeah, so I've been recording those on the, in orbit of. Board, cockpit.
Locks.
Yes, that should do it. I don't know what about to do about the music, but all of our spacey stuff hasn't really worked, or what. I can bring up some of those playlists again that I made, but I don't know how interesting they are. Yeah, no matter. Spacey musics. Right, we're off to Wolf then. Etheria ruins. That must be related to the press lines.
Drive, all good to go, Cap.
Grav jump. And engage.
Daring voyage of the oceans of space brings us here.
Cophonia. Cophonia? Cophonia. Yeah. I think the relaxes stuff is better. What have I got on this one? This was an interesting mix of spacey music. I mean, you could just say that I've been trying too hard and I should just use the music in the game. The Den.
Welcome to the Den. If you have business, feel free to land.
Is this the UC base? Is that why we're heading here? Not been here before. So I'm not too sure what to expect. Okay, that should do it. Dock. Then it will be X to board.
Time to cycle the airlock and move.
This station is but a shadow of its former purpose. Either she is here, or someone will know where we can find her.
Judea. Okay.
Anything Hello. I can help you with? Need some work done?
He's just able to modify again like some of the others.
Sure, have at it.
I mean, when you click modify, what sort of options do they even give you? Shipbuilder B. Or is it the same as like what you'd normally have? And if I try to make a new, how do you get a new piece? Add G, okay. Structural, Horizon, Deimos, Nova. they've got all the structural stuff then. I think. Bays. Cargo, cockpits, dockers, engines. Gear, grav drives, habs. He's got Dover and... He's got Deimos and Nova. That's all he's got. Right. It's interesting to know. I mean, I don't know for sure if we'll find out later on exactly what some of these guys have. It's worth checking. Oh, my word. It feels very cold today.
I understand this station was once quite the luxurious place for UC military commanders. Based on what I see, I find that very hard to believe.
Vending machines. Looking for.
Oh,
jeez, I'm much be tired of the normal.
That a big enough scoop for you?
The hell?
I really don't think that's appropriate talk coming from a Vanguard pilot.
That's exactly your problem. You don't think! If you weren't such a lousy reporter, you wouldn't be stuck all the way out here!
I mean, I guess maybe that's true, but... if so, you're just as stuck out here as I am. So what does that say?
Oh, wow! You really do want me to kick your ass, don't ya?
These guys hate each other.
All right, that's enough. Bastion, go cool off. Get a drink.
Whatever. Fine.
Holden. I appreciate that you have a job to do. I really do. But you need to consider that you don't operate in a vacuum. If you're stationed here long-term, that means you're around these people all day, every day. And they're not going to like it if you're making them look bad.
Lieutenant Commander Marquez, I appreciate your concern, but I have an obligation to SSNN to report on what I see.
I'm sure they do know that, Holden. I'm just saying, maybe use a little more discretion in your reporting. Maybe a lot. Don't worry. When the next big story breaks out here, I'll be sure to help you get the scoop, okay?
I will think on that. Thank you.
Hmm. All right. He's a reporter.
I try not to trade in gossip, but if you have any verifiable information, I'm all ears.
You seem a little out of place, Mr. Holden.
Well, I certainly feel that way. The Vanguard pilots don't seem to want to associate with me. And I don't agree with Mr. Romack's views on the colony war. So there are few options left to me. Hmm. You know, I really thought volunteering for this assignment was going to be the boost to my career that I was looking for. Now I suspect even SSNN has forgotten about me.
You'd always ask for a different assignment?
I could, so long as I don't mind seeming like an abject failure. And I just know that the day after I leave, some giant story will break. That seems to be the way things go.
Okay, tell me more about SSNN. I mean, we know about it.
Why, certainly. The Settled Systems News Network is the longest-running news service in... Well...
Ooh, so chilly.
The Settled Systems. Reporters are dispatched all over, keeping an ear to the ground for some breaking news that should be known to everyone. It can admittedly be a bit of a pain making sure those stories reach our central office in New Atlantis. But until someone invents faster than light communication, it's the best we can do.
All right.
Farewell then.
Okay. Right, we're looking for the lassie. Seems to me it wants me to talk to Reina?
Haven't seen you around here before. Welcome to the den. Reina Marquez. I head up the Vanguard station here. If you've got business with the Vanguard, I hope you ran it through MAST first. If not, you probably made a long jump for nothing.
Okay. What does the Vanguard do here?
The same thing we do everywhere else. Fill in the gaps for the UC Navy. Help keep the Settled Systems peaceful and safe. Sometimes it's a little bit of a challenge all the way out here, but we try our best.
We've not met many Vanguard
I wouldn't mind
yet.
A little more support from New Atlantis, but I know things are tough all over.
Yeah. Do you get a lot of action here?
Might be counterintuitive, but no. No, we don't. It's pretty quiet, and some of us deal with that better than others. We get the occasional distress call. Sometimes Varun stirs up trouble, but there's a lot of downtime.
Jeez.
I'm not complaining.
Tired, aren't I?
But others... Like Bastion there. It's not what he was expecting. Certainly not what he wanted.
Is the Vanguard always used this as a base of operations?
Oh, gosh, no. Vanguard wasn't even a thought back when this place was first built. The den, the original den, mind you, got blown up during the Serpent's Crusade. UC Navy immediately rebuilt the station, I think largely out of spite. Sometimes I think that's why they keep it operational, too. Certainly hasn't had much real purpose since the Colony War ended. I'm glad we have it as a post, and Marcel and the Trade Authority do some decent business, which I try very hard not to pay attention to. But the station has never recaptured that old glory.
Glory?
Don't think it ever will, really.
But if there's not much going on out here, then yeah, there's not, they're never going to have too much happening at the station. I'm looking for... Oh, this music's not... It's not right, is it? I can't pick anything good today. I really can't, so... Let's just go with the game. Stick it on 75. Right.
Quang? Twang. Really?
Oh, it's pronounced
there
Twang.
There are at least 3 other pilots based out of here I'd expect to receive complaints about first. Before we get started, I have to inform you
she
there's a
I'm
formal
here to complain.
Review process for the Vanguard, no. So don't expect any action for a while, okay? Now, what is the nature of your complaint?
We're not here to complain. You get lots of complaints then?
Look, this isn't Alpha Centauri or anything. We're a bit removed from the center of the United Colonies. Folks out here are a little less receptive to the Vanguard keeping an eye on things.
No, I just want to talk to her.
Oh, okay. Sorry, force of habit, I suppose. Jada isn't here. Hasn't been here in a while. In fact, she's following up on some sensitive information.
Okay.
I'm not sure I should disclose any more than that.
What if I said I already know she's hunting down Varun Zealots?
Then I'd probably just be wondering how you have any information at all. And I might even be more concerned about your intentions.
Ooh. Right. Now, I know what she's after. I have information that could help her.
It's not something I can just blurt out.
No, but that's why I'm going to persuade you, love. You don't seem to understand. I need this information now.
I do understand. I'm trying to figure out a way to help you, okay?
Oh, really? Right. Look, they have manipulation now, although I'm not going to use it if I can. I just need information. Nothing will ever connect back to you. Why are these... Some of these, like... Just the way they're worded is just really weird. I don't like it.
No, I can't.
Ugh.
Sorry.
Right, work something out.
This isn't getting us anywhere.
Oh, no, I failed.
The safety of my pilots has to come before anything else. I can't help you.
Okay.
Take care.
Well, that's one dead end, but apparently there's 2 places down here that we can
check. If you're
check.
Ever in New Atlantis...
It's the bar by the looks of it. Oh, nice. Yeah, it has a bar. I like the... Got like a framed picture. I wonder if it's the person the bar's named after. And a UC coffee mug, which we haven't got. We haven't got one of those yet.
It would seem more prudent that the UC simply shut down this entire station rather than allow it to endure in this
Romac.
Hey there. Ain't seen you before.
What brings you to the den? Just passing through. I'm on a mission.
Ah, man with a purpose. Good, I like that. Don't worry, I won't ask questions. I know well as anyone that secrets ought to stay secret. Well, you're welcome here, so long as I don't hear you disrespecting the United Colonies military. You got a problem with our history or our heroes? And you can find somewhere else to get yourself a drink. Clear?
Yeah. Okay. Seems like this place has seen better days. I need to locate Jada Huang.
That's so. Vanguard pilot. A pretty good one from what I hear. Got a real attitude, though. You could always ask the other Vanguard pilots. Or, since you're already here, I do happen to offer services in exchange for payment.
Ooh.
One of those services can be information. You get what I'm saying here?
Isn't this extortion?
Nah, not at all. There's got to be coercion for it to count as extortion. This is just good old-fashioned business.
Well, we haven't been able to get information otherwise, so...
then I will tell you that I happen to overhear she's out in the Groombridge system. And from what I hear, Reyna ain't happy about it. And our little transaction here is concluded. Pleasure doing business.
So, seems like this place has seen better days.
Tell me something I don't know. You should have seen this place 30 years ago. UC's best and brightest were in and out of here all the time. But then the colony war and, well, most folks don't like to be honest about that. I ain't one to turn my back on those who saved us in those days. And because I won't dishonor the memory of Ve Victus, business dries up. Ain't my problem that people don't like to face the reality of what happens in wartime. Man was a hero, not a traitor.
Tell me more about this Ve. That must be the picture he's got up.
Oh, he was a brilliant man. Just brilliant. Best leader we could have asked for in a crisis. He made the tough decisions no one else could. Did what needed to be done. Saved our asses. And when it was over, they turned on him. Called him a traitor and executed him. Just shameful. Well, not all of us are just gonna go along with rewriting history. Some of us remember.
Finally got your new PC.
Ve Victus sacrificed everything to save the United Colonies. That's what a real hero does.
So what are you gonna do? Now you can get on Starfield, or have you begun it already? Are you going to... What sort of background, character, role are you going to put together? Do you have something in mind, or you're just going to wing it? I'm looking for work, am I? Well, we'll see what he offers.
Well, now that depends. You support the UC? Consider yourself a patriot?
I'll support anything where there are credits involved.
Huh. Ain't a great answer, but I've heard worse. All right, maybe you can help me out. Had some posters made up a while back to remind folks of the good work Ve Victus has done for all of us. Try and push back against all the lies the government tells.
Started already.
I put
same
them up
character.
Here, but that's caused some friction with the Vanguard pilots.
You ran like garbage in your old PC. Go to waste, though.
If a strong-willed, patriotic individual, such as yourself, were to make sure some of them were placed where they could inspire the people of the United Colonies, well, that'd be something. And there'd be some credits in it for anyone helping out the UC. What do you think?
Sure, I don't mind putting up some posters. We've done this before. This is interesting. Where do you suggest we put them?
I was thinking the well might
You've
be
made
a good
space
spot.
Rascal.
People down there might be more receptive, don't you think?
How far do you think you're in now then, Sid? My housemate's trying to build a PC as well. To promote a murderer. Did he murder people? I'll say sure.
That's the spirit. All right. Posters are in the back there, and you just let me know when you're done.
I don't know if we know how.
Selection might not be the best, but you're welcome to any of it.
We don't know much about this bloke yet, anyway. Let's have a look at his drinks. Does he have anything unique? Nah, Solomon's Reserves, Patty Melts. Kodos Crater. Typical stuff, nothing unique.
Long live the UC.
Not very
Only
far
a matter of time.
Well, that's good then, Sid, because that means you've got plenty to look forward to. That's a damn game. Every time I click off the game, it freezes. Because there's no way to do it so that it doesn't do that. It tends to freak out regardless. But he's got some posters there, so why does he need more?
Freewheeling space ace.
No, I need to quickly grab a hoodie. Because for some reason I'm absolutely freezing today, so I need to find something warm. Ow! I think I kicked the wrong thing. Because I quite enjoyed my dinner, but it hasn't warmed me up much. Like, it was a nice bit of rice and.
Sidnicus just subscribed on Twitch.
Friend, good.
Sid! You've subscribed, Sid! Welcome to the pay per viewers. Well, let me take this helmet off. Helmet? Earphones. Oh, no, thank you very much, Sid. That means we're now at, is it 7? I thought we were already at 7. Did not go up. Sometimes it doesn't seem to trigger correctly. Let me try again.
That's right.
Now it's gone up. Oh.
She's my friend and she needed help. If I had to, I'd pee on any one of you.
Right. No, I remember now. I think I originally actually had it like the other way around. Yeah, I did. I had it the other way around so that it triggers that after the clip plays, because it's like it hasn't counted yet at Twitch's side for like a minute. So I was always getting it to update after. Where the bollocks is it though on my system? Twitch. Subscriber event. There we are, yeah. Update count. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, there we go. That should do it. Though I need to make improvements. I wanted to have a lot more stuff happen when people subscribe, but I haven't been able to think of too much other than the shower of hearts and corgis. You saw 7-8, so I had to check that prime. Check that prime. Ah, yeah, see, prime. I wanted something separate for primes as well. I was going to try and get a bunch of clips that are related to Amazon Prime. I've got two sets of music playing. Let's turn that off. I've been trying to decide. We've been experimenting. Customer.
Welcome.
Oh, this is a shop.
I really did think this place would see a bit more action.
Been trying to experiment what sort of music would work in the background of the game.
Ever run into spacers? Scumbags and scavengers.
They're been like trying a bit of space music and jazz music, but they just doesn't... We haven't found anything that fits too well. It's just because the game, you can tell here right now, the game's really quiet a lot of the time. The music's just really... I mean, in some ways, it's pleasant. It's nice and calm, but it does get a little bit dry.
Welcome to the boring. Trade Authority. I'm Marcel, and if there's anything I can do for you, please, do let me know.
Do let me know.
Our stock may not be as vast as New Atlantis or Sidonia, but I will do my best to see that you leave here.
Well, that's why outside. That's why we were experimenting
and
with some jazz.
The Trade Authority is the only fully licensed operator for the den. I'm afraid your alternatives are, shall we say, slim.
Is he saying he's the only shop? I could try the jazz again. It's just fine. It just seems to be difficult to find like the right sort of playlist. When I click, I've gone into actual jazz and I've got a mixture here of sentimental, hopeful, peaceful, relaxing, mysterious, dreamy, elegant, smooth, laid back, lounge, jazz lounge, funny, floating, like, what are these? This is the one our playlist I was using yesterday. So let's use some of this again, I guess. Yeah. Though I'll need to tweak the game settings again. Just turn off the
It
music.
Is a pleasure to make your acquaintance, and I hope this and all future interactions are profitable for both of us.
Like, it's not the same as the, you know, the radio. Maybe they'll end up adding a radio. I mean, there's the SSNN, but I'm just surprised that, like, you know, that we can't just... I mean, we've got the watch. Surely the watch can get radio signals. A radio mod would be good. Yeah, you'd probably have to use a lot of free music for it. But I mean, that could be cool. I wonder if I could. I mean, I've never made a mod before, but I'd like to experiment and see if I could make some things. Space radio, Slightly Wilson, might be good. I just record myself going, "Welcome to Space Radio."
If there's anything I can do for you, please don't hesitate.
Deliver message. This is from Duncan Lynch. Did I have a message to give this guy a message?
Thank you. Did you have any trouble en route?
Quite random. Yeah. It was small sailing.
Good. Very good. Here's your pay, and your continued discretion would be appreciated.
I think actually, yeah, one of the other trade guys gave me a quest
How
to give him
How may the Trade Authority assist you? I hope we have what you need.
Yeah, let's see what he does have for sale. Resources. Rough site magnets and iridium. Bisc digipicks. Aid. Battle stimulimalims things. Well, by the way, the Trade for Folly, they tend to like buying stuff that's stolen. And I think I've randomly have a Christmas Carol stolen. So let me get rid of it, because I don't want to be carrying around a book that's stolen. I try not to steal stuff, but sometimes I end up with really random things like that. Yeah. Alright, no matter. Okay, we've got the hint we needed of where the lassie is. So hopefully we'll go there. I think it's stupid, look, that they're saying inaccessible, so I can't go in anyway, but then it also tells me that if I went in, it'd count as, like, illegal actions, stealing, etc. They've got a nice little screen there. I've never seen one of those before. Let's have a better look at it. Photo mode, V, T. Anything with a screen, just in case I could use it later, I've been collecting data on. Let's have a go, field of view. So I've been just cataloguing every single one that we find. There you go, nice, save it. That's it, done. Send that to my Discord. Yeah, brilliant. Right, and dock. So what are you going to focus on first, Sid? Main quest? Side quests? Planet exploration?
We're free.
Or are you just going to set out into the galaxy and see what we can find? See what you can find? Let's pull up our map then. So we're going to find the lassie. Don't know where she'll be, but yeah, let's have a look. So, Groombridge is the last known location. So that's where we'll jump to. Okay, here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, engage! Not as dramatic as I'd like, but...
Yes, we're here. Look at those beautiful stars.
Unidentified ship. You are not authorized to be here. State your business.
Who's that? Ah, that lassie there.
Who the hell are you? And what are you doing here?
We tell her that we're Andrea. Okay. What are you doing out here? We know who she is. Okay, well, I'm here with Andrea. We've been looking for you.
You're what? You've got to be kidding me. She... You...
We're about to be attacked, aren't we? Not her, but like...
Shit. I've got multiple ships inbound. Too late to run.
Yeah.
Sure hope you're prepared for a fight.
I was like, it's just gonna happen. Here, now, I'm like, oh, okay, yeah, we're about to get attacked by the Varun. Okay, follow. Engage!
Got their grab drive.
That's one of them. Okay, next one. Last one. Oh, is repair. It's been fun learning the,
Nice! They just lost their grab drive. Target's shield system is
fine. You're not going anywhere for a while. So why don't you tell me what the hell you think you're doing, showing up here now?
We are here because she wants to make up for what happened years ago.
10 years after the fact?
Yeah.
With nothing in between? You'll have to forgive me if I find that hard to believe. Suspicious, even. Look, my grav drive is fried. I need time to repair, if I can even manage it. You didn't take the opportunity to blow me up. So either that's not your goal, or you're playing some long game. You want to explain yourself? I can't stop you from coming over here. But I'm gonna be armed, and it's gonna be aimed at her head. Just so we're clear.
Okay. Right, we can enter a ship then. Dock with R. It's a small ship. Smaller than ours.
And we're docking.
Board. Open.
How can you possibly show your face?
I am glad to see that you are safe, Jada. I am sorry if this is difficult for you.
Difficult? Are you serious right now? You set us up, killed my friends, and then a decade later you show up like nothing happened?
The drama.
Have you lost your mind?
Set you up? I was not behind that. It was zealots, you know that. We were all attacked.
This music, man.
Don't bullshit. Not now. Who the hell are you? You're a backup dancer?
Backup dancer? You have a very interesting way of speaking. I'm a friend of Andrea's, that's all.
I was too a ways back. You can see how that's worked out for me. What are you doing here with her? You don't look like Varun to me.
Oh, she doesn't know what she's been up to. But then again, it's been 10 years. Okay. You hate zealots, we hate zealots.
Yeah. Difference is, though, I haven't been working with them. She has.
I would never...
You know, for a while I told myself it was a coincidence that you disappeared.
It does add an interesting vibe having jazz music on.
You were long gone when the dust settled. Told myself, no, it couldn't possibly be her. Not after all those years we spent working together. We're friends. So I went after the zealots. And then I found out the truth. Your damned High Council. They knew. Told the zealots where to find us.
Oh, really?
That's not true. That cannot be true.
Oh, it is.
How? How do you know this? If you have proof, I need to see it right now.
You don't get to demand anything of me, Andreja. I know what I've seen.
So you were working with House Varun. Why would you want... Why would they want to kill you?
Because we were a loose end. We knew things, locations, names. They never trusted us. We were just a mess that needed cleaning up.
Okay. You don't believe Andreas? I don't believe Andreas is involved. The High Council isn't either. Show us the proof. Yeah.
Don't have. It doesn't work like that. I've put things together over the years. Slates, communications, interrogations.
A name, Jada. Give me a name. You must have heard one by now.
Thomasar. Thomasar Kadik. That's the bastard from the High Council who's been helping the zealots.
And did you hear this from Aaron?
Aaron? What? No. I haven't talked to him in a year. What do you know about it?
Jada, I swear on the serpent himself, I would never betray you. I need time to make this right. Can we go somewhere and talk?
I am not giving up on this. I've tracked them this far, and I'm going to see this through. You want your proof? Well, they have it.
You think you've won?
That's him! That's the bastard responsible for the ambush! If you're not lying to me, then you better help me take him down!
Is he here?
I just have to destroy you both! Get back to your ship!
I guess we need to get back to our ship. It was interesting seeing what hers is like on the inside. Alright. Alright, we better head back then. If that's the case, cockpit.
I smile today in the knowledge that the great serpent has truly blessed my ship and my crew. Why else would he have delivered ship from dawn. Me the dregs of our purge?
Oh, there they are.
The awful that escaped our righteous justice.
Do I need to try and try and get on board? How do I view, like, zoom in?
Gave you over to us to atone for their sins.
I don't know how to, like, zoom in on this one. Oh, there it is. Ow, what just happened? You smash into me. I can't seem to lock onto the engines. No, they've been blown up. Wait, is he still talking? Was he still talking, but the ship was destroyed? There's nothing in it. Now what? Chat with her again? Well, there it is, target lock. Ah, okay. Why didn't it tell me that before? Oh. It didn't let me hail. Instead, I've gotten out.
Dusty! Dusty! Dusty!
Who's Dusty? What? What are you going on about, Barrett?
Lost in my thoughts, but glad to be back.
That's quite random.
We'll talk more later. Don't worry.
Hey, Captain.
This is quite a big... Forget the term. Bridge? Yeah. I kind of want to find one with four seats in it. There's a few spaceships that I want to see if I can't build. Why is there a Tritonic clamp just sitting there on the floor? One of which would need four seats in the cockpit. No, two of which even. So I guess I'm just gonna have to redock. It's a bit unpaced though to have to like dock, undock, kill them, then reboard? Like, because I can't just radio her again? Well, let's see what she has to say.
The two of you have got a lot of goddamn nerve.
Oh no, that's it. Wait, hang on. I want to talk to Andrea.
I do not understand. It cannot be possible that the High Council would betray us like that. He must have been lying.
Let's go ask them.
That is not an option.
Oh.
Even if we could reach them, you are a non-believer. You would be killed.
Really? Something I thought only the zealots would do that. Why would the
right?
That's so stupid. That makes them all zealots. If
the code at the bottom.
Ugh.
I have seen this before.
Bottom of
what? I know where we need to go.
What?
I must explain. House Barun values secrecy above nearly all else. Those of us sent out into the settled systems, we cannot return.
Really? They can't force you to stay away forever.
Maybe not forever, but certainly until our mission has been accomplished. When we are assigned a mission, we are taken to a point outside of House Barun's domain. We do not jump ourselves. We are never given the coordinates for Barun Kai, our homeworld. We literally cannot return. Only a select few are ever trusted with that knowledge. I can never go home. Unless I am permitted.
No, that's what she meant before then about how, you know, it's outside the settled systems. Yeah. I wonder if we can find it accidentally. Like, if we are systematically checking every planet and moon, do you think we'd eventually find it? Interesting. Okay. They get points for ingenuity, I'll give them that.
It is a system that has never failed them. I'm certain.
It's quite interesting.
But perhaps this system has become the problem. I cannot travel to my home, but I can reach out another way. But it means putting you in danger in a way you have not been before. I cannot say for certain what will happen.
I signed on for this no matter what.
Thank you.
I did like that last one.
A great deal.
I didn't have anything else to
There's
do today.
There's an old derelict star station where I may get answers.
Oh, really?
I know that seems vague. It will become clear when we arrive.
Maybe they used to use it as a base. It could be like that. Okay. Cockpit.
It is good.
Right, now we'll undock.
Ship's clear.
Okay.
It's just us among the stars again, Captain.
Well, I will just quickly grab some of these, some of these objects before we leave. Is the next one? Over there. I was trying to dodge the asteroids, but the asteroids are going with me because they're bugged. Like, I know I could use console commands to fix it so they disappear, but I don't want to... I don't want to do that, damn it. I don't want to do that, seeing as I know it'll disable... It will disable achievements if I do that. Okay, nuclear foregrad, right. Done. Right, we're going to head then to the next location. So where is this space station she wants us to head to? In Murfarid. Right. Oh, it's right there. Set course X. Now we'll whoop, grav drive. I mean, you can aim the grav jump directly at the moon, and it wouldn't matter. Thing is, I feel like it should matter because. Wait, the grav drives, grav jumps really should be aimed directly at the place you're going to. It's not like you've opened a wormhole or anything like that, and it's not like hyperspace where you would just jump from one location to the other in like a split second that you wouldn't even visibly notice. Grav jumps fold space so that you'd be closer to the object that you're aiming at. But that's the point. The ship would still need to be aimed at the object. Well, at least I think so. I guess it depends how grav drives work exactly. We've not found any descriptions in game yet. I might have to do some more theories. Okay, so this is saying that there's no one here, or at least no one, nobody answering the comms. I guess we'll see when we
locked and we are docked.
When we board, I guess we'll find out what's going on inside. Seems right. Abandoned. Switch to. I don't know what.
Say again. There is danger for you here. Likely for us both. I need you to trust me. These stations were built by the United Colonies during the Serpent's Crusade. They were abandoned when.
I'm gonna make a new save here.
Peace was brokered.
I can't remember when we last saved.
They are an excellent place to hide in plain sight.
Because it's a space station. I mean, when these space stations are abandoned, they'd usually fall to ruin so fast that there wouldn't even be oxygen on board. Like, you know, then none of the power systems and stuff would keep going. Oh, is this a secret door?
Before we go any further, I cannot stress this enough. Keep your weapons at your side. Do not make any sudden moves.
Okay.
Do nothing to appear hostile.
What are we walking into here?
This is the only place I can get answers. The only connection I have to House Varun. Please give me a moment.
Ooh. She appears to be hot wiring the wall. Did the animation just restart? Oh no, there you go. Wall panel's not closed though, it stayed up. So it was a secret panel behind a wall. Now we've proceeded to another part of the space station. Better follower. I'm guessing there's more of a run hidden in here then. And if I set it to walking only, she still walks slightly faster than me. That's funny, that. Is that the bloke? He's it's rather quiet, the voice.
I am not the one who needs to explain himself, Tommisar.
I am surprised by your tone. What has gotten into you? This is very unlike you. Almost insubordinate.
I know what you have done.
He does,
the
he sounds quiet.
You've sent.
You are not making any sense. Of course I send you messages. That is how this works. That is how it has always worked.
Not to me. To the zealots. To the fanatics who murdered my friends, who tried to murder me.
You must be mistaken. Mm. Or perhaps confused. Nothing like that has ever happened.
Enough! I have the transcripts, Tommisar. You did this. You told them where to find us.
Now, let's just take a moment. No one wants to make accusations they might regret. You. You are from that Constellation group. I've heard all about you.
Good things,
you
I hope.
You turned her against me, filled her head with lies.
No,
this
what?
Will not be allowed no. to stand.
I didn't even do anything. You an ass. I'm here to support my friend, something it seems she's been lacking.
Insolence! You have corrupted her!
I said enough! This is between you and me.
This has gone far enough. Talk some sense into her at once.
What? Why would
Neither
I do
you
that?
Dare lift a finger against me, against House Varun.
You think you can just keep lying?
I have already said this is a misunderstanding.
Maybe being a little more honest would help.
But I am.
Are you?
If you let Andreja hurt me, I am her only link to the High Council, to House Varun. Without me, she can never return home. You must make her listen to reason.
He is responsible. He deserves to die.
Did you not hear me? You do this, you lose everything.
I heard you. I know what it costs me. But he deserves it. Does he not?
He does, but you don't want to... don't want to put yourself in a position where you can never go home. No matter how crazy the people there are. Is there so other way?
I do not know. Maybe. Maybe if the High Council sees what he has done.
Show the Council, let them deal with him? Yeah, that feels better.
Fine.
At least they'll send someone else.
Fortunate. You get to live.
This is not over. The High Council will hear of your treason.
No,
perhaps
your treason.
They'll hear of your actions as well, Tommisar. Think on that.
How are we going to get a message to them then?
Let us leave this place. I wish to return to the lodge.
You will regret this!
How would we, Oh, look, if I take everything, it doesn't count as stealing. Hooray! I mean, is there anything around here even worth really having? Med packs? Credits? Jeez, there's a lot of credits in this box. Take them. Did you pick? Trucker helmet? Nah. Get some credits, baby. Refined rattler. Ammo. Does he not have any, like, data pads or anything where we can learn some interesting stuff?
See you punished for your impudence.
Funky sphere sculpture. I'm a bit nonplussed by this. I don't really understand too much of what's actually gone on in the end. Like, it's been a bit confusing. I see what... Does he have anything he has to say? No.
I assure you.
So it's that she...
Something important or just conversation? Of course. What would you like to know?
You want any more information for me? Because I'm so confused. How does the den figure into all of this?
It is relatively well trafficked, but there are fewer prying eyes than some other locations. The UC Vanguard has operated out of the den for some time, but they are poorly staffed and supplied. It can be a good handoff point for smugglers.
When you tell me about this Commissar Kadiak.
I understand he has connections within the High Council. I do not know much more about him. It was never my job to know. As I have said, he is the one who has given
right,
me assignments.
Yes, that's what I was
he
expecting.
Sent me to hire smugglers like Aaron and Jada and coordinate transport missions for them. He would have known their names, but I cannot imagine that he would ever contact them directly.
So was that she? So she is an operative of House Varun, right? Again, she is in deep. She's part of the original family, and is therefore considered high up in the not the actual main top house, but high up anyway. They sent her out as an operative. He's her handler. She was handling smugglers. She abandoned them and treated them badly. And then he, for some reason, has
another
sent.
Time.
He sent the fanatics out against her, and they've tracked down. They've tracked down her smugglers and killed one of them and was trying to kill the other. Oh, free stuff! Yay! And now, and rather than kid him, we've persuaded her to tell House Varun. I think all these robots would have come out if we'd attacked. Yeah. That's how it's gone in the end, then. But I am still a little nonplussed, because I feel like there should be an awful lot more to this than what we've found. Hey, contraband. I mean, contraband bad contraband. But at the same time, I'm still gonna take it. I'm not bothering to do the saves. I can't anymore, actually. It doesn't feel half the time like it's even worth it. Work our ass off to open a safe, but then all that's inside is there might be some credits, but then the rest of it will probably be that's it. Like maybe an odd item too. That's it then, there really isn't much else here. I mean, it's kind of cool as a setting that he has a secret base inside this abandoned space station. And that's where the Varun are working out of. Empty oxygen booster. I haven't found one of them before, have I? No. It's a new one. But then I also feel like it's kind of a waste of a space station, because there's nothing else going on here. It's just abandoned, like. I like how in space, look, when you go back to bed, then it's always just normal 24-hour time again.
Come on, there are worlds to conquer.
There's a painting there. Bit spontaneous. Beds and beds and beds, Frankenstein. Like, I thought we'd find a lot more unique books, but we just don't seem to be finding more of them either. So it's funny you could just end up exploring this whole space station, but it's just completely empty. There's nobody here. Why it would be kept functioning. But I'm also nonplussed as to how that dude is here by himself. Maybe it's better to keep it that way so that he doesn't get caught. But I just again find that quite surprising, because it's like there's no way he can run this entire space station by himself, because he needs to keep the light on, he needs to keep the energy going, or he'd end up dying. Festive Neon City poncho. A festive poncho. I like that sculpture. If we can build one of those later. Bolt cutters galore. Let's drop down. Separate area. workstations. Yeah. It's coffee. But there is no coffee in the coffee bag. It is an empty coffee bag. What a shame, what a shame. What's that there? No. Just really expected to find some more interesting stuff. There really isn't anything else here. This is the secret base to the entire Settled Systems Varun operation. And there's just nothing here. There's nothing here. Hey, it's a mug. I found a mug. We've been collecting mugs. When there's a... Is that a stick? Exotic wood decoration. Huh. Not sure if I have one of those already. Well, there's a grubby. What are you doing there, grubby?
I hope nobody... wherever you store that this...
Yeah, didn't mean to open it.
Smell will not be an issue.
I'm not bringing the grub with me, lassie. Why would I bring the grub with me? Right, we'll head back to... We'll head back to the lodge.
We're clear.
But the question is now then, surely this is not the end of the mission. How do we pass on the information to the, go to the lodge? Yeah, okay. Well, since it's here, it's a little easier to go show on map. Oh, wait, I've just picked up a bunch of contraband. Well, then in that case, let us take it to my contraband stash place in Port Naga. Since you're subscribed, Sid, is there any, you're gonna pick the name of one of my bases. I've got a few that I haven't named yet. What would you suggest as a base name? Could be related to your name or not. Let's pop inside. Airlock one, airlock two. And then this is the... No, that's the one that's usually slightly less empty. Though I don't know, I'm getting to the point now where it might be pretty full. Right, store these six, store those five. Containers at max capacity. Yeah, I knew it was going to happen soon. I'll just have to give up then. Giving I could build another one. Though it is starting to feel a little bit pointless. Let's have a look. How do we do it again? So open that, then press R. Then I'm on build mode. Okay. Never done this with keyboard and mouse controls. Power, storage, builders, structures, crafting, defenses, robots, furniture, storage crate. There we go. And then I just need to change it to... How do I pick which one we want? Variants Q and T. Why Q and T? They're very weird, some of these. Rotates mouse one and mouse two. Okay. It's very sensitive, though. Not easy to try and align it the way you'd want it. I can't get it straight. It's not quite straight. Can't do it. It's not like it rotates when you move left and right, so... I can't get it exactly straight. Look at that little line on the floor. I'm trying to line it up with that, yeah? So that it's straight with the wall. Oh no. It's so close, but it won't. I can't do it. It just won't work. No, come on. How annoying. Damn game. I mean, I know it looks almost, but it'll drive me insane if it's not straight. Let's turn it all the way around. Maybe. Oh. See, I can... almost get it that way. Admittedly, I don't even know if they're straight. Maybe that's it. Maybe the building's slightly wonky and therefore I can't ever get it straight. Epic fail. I give up. I just give up. I can't deal with this. Right, let's build it. Done. And then I can exit build mode. And I can stick it in here. Some point I'm going to have to try and sell some of this crap, but I don't really know how to do it. There we go. Store. Confirm. Well, there's the Hong Kong snow globe, but I'll put that in the lodge. Oh, I can see them now, can I? It wouldn't work before, but now I can see them, eh? About the London one. Where's the London one? London snow globe. Oh, there you go. So it's got what, the shard? Is that meant to be the Houses of Parliament and the London Eye? And then you've got a couple of trees and one red bus. Right, and there's the Hong Kong one. Okay. And it's just showing like the main skyscraper. I wouldn't know what it's called. So that's three then. I've now found three snow globes, because that including the one we found on the moon with the lunar lander. That's three snow globes collected. There probably is an awful lot more, I'm sure. I'm sure there's a lot more. I haven't found anything else yet. Don't know why I'm jumping up to the ship, actually. We don't really need to come up here. Look at all the glitched asteroids following me around. Damn things. Just ruin the view. Just ruin the horizon. Okay, map. Tab back out. Go to the lodge. Then we'll go have a chat with Andrea here. See what she has to say for herself. How are we going to get this message to House Varun? And I said, it does seem like I'm not going to be able to go there. Maybe they'll add in House Varun as a DLC. I don't mind that really, but I would have preferred the DLCs to have really interesting all-time low stuff. Hang on. Where does it want me to go specifically? Accompany her to the lodge. Well, that's where I am. I'm in the lodge. Yeah. It wants me to go... Is it up to the bar? It could be. Might be she wants me to go up to the bar so that she can have a chat with me there. Yeah? Oh, no. Further in. Her room? Are we going to her room? I don't really see why we would. Oh, this must be her room then. Explains a lot. Got all the weapon cases. Yeah, come in here and have a chat with us, lassie.
How can I assist? Thank you for coming back here with me. I fear that after all that has happened, I am unsure of my place in House Varun. This room may now be the only place I have left to call home.
Don't jump to conclusions. We don't know what will happen. So she hasn't even tried. Is it maybe because she doesn't know how to get a message to the House Varun? I find that to be this has been a very weird side quest. Don't jump to conclusions. You don't know what will happen. Whatever happens next, we'll face it together.
It is reassuring to hear you say that. Still. I do not know how to live without some connection to House Varun. The Great Serpent has always been a guiding force in my life. The force that drives all that I do. What if I have lost that?
You don't need House Varun. You have a family constellation. The connection to the Great Serpent is never through Thomas Sire. It's still there inside you. I mean, you know, don't disrespect her beliefs, so, you know. If House Varun abandons you now, they're making a huge mistake. Forget all about this. Put the past behind you. You know, we'll cheer her up. She's worried about you know, house run of the serpent, so.
Yes, that is true. Whatever else has happened or will happen, the Great Serpent still holds a purpose for me. You have been by my side through all of this, the most turbulent time in my life. And you have supported me faithfully. I have never been able to count on any single person the way I have with you.
Really?
If I am repeating myself, you will have to forgive me. I cannot overstate what it means to me.
I mean, she did abandon all the other ones, didn't she? That's what best friends are for, isn't it? We're not best friends, are we? Right.
I have never had a best friend, but I believe that sounds right. So if we are to be best friends, then I shall do everything I can to be there for you in the way that you have for me. How can I sit here feeling sorry for myself when there is so much for us to do?
Okay, that's it, yeah. Drea considers you an ally.
Yes, you need something?
Was that it then? That was the the end of her side mission. I really expected more from it. I don't know why. Considering it, you know, it was meant to be like related to House Faerun and everything. I really thought it would, but no, apparently not. Hang on. It's not even shown up as part of the completed missions. Yeah. Oh, it's there. Okay, maybe they show up in the order that you've got them. Could be. I'm not entirely sure. Very odd that. Right. I don't know what else to do now.
A face I never mind seeing.
Maybe we just need to pick a random one. But what I'll do is I am going to switch her over.
You will be lost without me, but as you wish.
The only one I haven't done as a side quest for was Sarah. So we're going to go grab Sarah, as we just saw her in the bar. So we'll go pick her up from the bar. Sarah Morgan! Hello, Miss Morgan!
You've got something for me?
Yes.
Yes?
Are you ready to head back out?
I'm right behind you.
Okay, act a companion. Perfect. I don't know if she has anything else to say now we've grabbed her.
Hey.
Personal questions?
Sure, go ahead.
Nah, we've asked all of those.
Talk to you later.
Okay. Yeah, do I pick something random then? I mean, I've been avoiding the main missions for a while, but I've mostly been doing them offline because I don't want people to see any spoilers that are there. Faction ones are faction ones, but we only have that first one for the Free Star Collective, yeah. But you had to, for the main missions, you had to go and deal with the bank robbers. And then it automatically put you on the quest tree, therefore, for quest line for joining. What's this bottom one then? Light in the Darkness. Oh no, that's just find new stories, yeah. I do have this scanner to go find power from beyond. So we could do that one. Might as well actually click on it, because I've got loads of these. I don't know how I've ended up with so many of them. Sometimes they just show up. So let me do a B. Scanner anomaly. And we'll head there. Did that say Jemison? No, it's from Jemison. Jumping from Jemison.
I have something I need to discuss with you.
Oh, okay, that was quite sudden, but okay, Sarah.
Ever since we talked about the Battle of Cassiopeia, I can't get what happened out of my mind.
The Battle of Cassiopeia. One of her things she went to, where she said a bunch of them died, and everything I said to her made her angry with me. Okay. I told you, it wasn't your fault.
I know, but that's not the point. This isn't about fault. This is about closure. until I return to Cassiopeia, I'll never be able to put this to rest.
Oh, does she want me to go there now? Will it put your concerns to rest?
The last time I saw my crew, their escape shuttle was headed for the planet's surface. I need to find the wreckage to ensure their memories are honored.
Okay. And seeing the wreckage isn't going to bring back your cube, but sure, let me help you.
I would like that. Actually, I need that. One problem, though. Pinpointing the crew's shuttle wreckage is going to be like trying to find a grain of salt in a sandbox.
Can't easily scan it.
I think we need to start by locating my old campsite on Cassiopeia 1.
All of the Dauntless escaped... what actually happened to the Dauntless in the end?
Shortly after I evacuated, I saw the ship come apart.
That's what she said, yeah.
The UC listed it as lost, so I assume the Dauntless was completely destroyed.
And all their escape shuttles were damaged as well?
The Dauntless took heavy fire to the docking section during the battle. We had three shuttles. One was destroyed, and the other two were damaged. There was no other way off the ship.
Hmm. You were lucky you made it out. Yeah, you're lucky you made it out safely.
Lucky? Compared to my crew, I hit the goddamn jackpot. Still, I'll never forget my finger hovering over that launch button. Would I launch safely or explode into a fireball? It turned out that my shuttle had just enough power to allow an emergency landing on the planet's surface.
Oh, controller time. Okay, yeah, we'll switch to controller for now then, guys. Yeah, I'm back on controller. It's impressive you soft landed after an emergency jettison that close to the exosphere.
I wouldn't call what I did a soft landing. But thank you all the same.
Heyo, Death Wish. Thanks for popping me back to control. How are you? How are you this fine day? If you haven't seen it before, actually, yeah, look, I've got this is my Starfield controller. I got to match the game. Good, says Deathwish. That is good. Sweet. Yes. What do you know about Cassiopeia 1?
It has a breathable atmosphere, indigenous fauna, and
no, I didn't buy the headset.
Maybe a few abandoned mining outposts. Otherwise, it's not populated.
I already have an Xbox headset, which I don't actually really ever use. I mean, I could use it, but I actually kind of like having the white one rather than the black. Of course, the new Xbox One was a white one too. But it seems like a massive waste of money to buy one when I already need one. I'm always needing new controllers. They break all the time, damn it. So I definitely wanted the controller. And it's not as expensive as a headset. So, what do you hope to find at the old campsite?
My shuttle should have the telemetry tracking data for the other shuttle aboard.
Really?
It should give us an idea where it went down. That's if scavengers haven't completely stripped my ship for parts.
Is she sure that nobody else survived then? Do you think putting this all rest will get you back on your feet?
Don't worry. It's not as though I'm coming apart at the seams. It's the conversations we've been having. They dredged up these old memories and they're a burden.
Okay. We'll set course for the Cassiopeia system.
Hold on. I don't know the exact location of my survival campsite.
She doesn't.
For that, we are going to have to head to Mast and see if we can get the information from my old friend, Admiral Logan.
Huh. Okay. I'm sensing tension between you and Logan, then.
Your instincts are right on target. Logan and I butted heads more than once during my time with a Navigator Corps. We've never seen eye to eye. Look, I hope this isn't asking too much. Last thing I want to do is drag you into some kind of personal crusade.
Crusades are my specialty. I mean, would you like the designs on the headset and the controller? Would you buy them, Deathwish? I've owned quite a lot of controllers. I guess special edition ones over the years. I'm sure I had a Halo one back in the day. I think I had a Destiny PlayStation one. But I would say that this is the nicest one I've ever had. It's not as good as an Elite controller, but it's pretty damn close. Pretty damn close. Yeah. Members of Constellation, stick together. Your well-being is important to me.
That's why I'm desperate for your help.
Desperate?
Truth is, I'm scared. When I set foot on Cassiopeia, I don't know if I'll be able to handle what I find. If I begin to fall apart, I need someone I can trust to hold me together.
Hmm. What are you expecting to find? Well,
besides bad memories?
The shuttle.
I don't know. I'm trying not to think about it. Not yet.
Hmm. Okay. You're too tough to fall apart. I'll have you back.
I know you will. You've always been there when I've needed your help. Why you continue to support me, I'll never understand.
It's because I love you, Sarah. It's because I care what happens to you. It's what friends do for one another. It's because I care what happens to you, Sarah, yeah.
I feel the same way about you. Oh, I've been so busy.
I love your back. You can have my dick.
I've overlooked what's been in front of me all this time.
That'd be a very interesting pickup line, Death Wish.
Something I've denied myself for far too long.
I like all these weird creatures walking around in the background. What about Azure? Why Azure?
Traveling out here with you, I've discovered that friendships change by circumstance. I worked closely with Aja on long space voyages, so we became friendly. When she quit Constellation, the friendship ended. But I'm certain at this point, even if you and I were separated by a great distance, we'd never lose touch.
Don't start crying on me. That ends today. You've been critical of yourself for far too long, Sarah.
You're right. I have. Hey, anyway, I've taken up enough of your time. I know you have a lot to do. I really appreciate your offer to visit Cassiopeia. Hopefully, it'll bring me the closure that I've needed for far too long.
You're damn right. There's almost all,
I'd like to speak to you.
Well, again, we've just talked.
Look.
Oh.
I wanted to take this opportunity to thank you. The fact that you risked your life to save me, I don't know what to say.
Say high five. Your thank you is more than enough. I accept thanks in the form of credits. You would have done the same for me. How far are you in the game? You've been playing for a long time now. I know, we've done probably 200 hours, Death Wish. And honestly, I have no idea how far we are into the game.
Well, yes, of course. But that's beside
We've
the point.
Surveyed 57
my
planets.
My wish is that my rescue hadn't come at the expense
I think there's...
He was one of my closest colleagues.
I think the total is something like 1,600. Oh, we're only at 57.
I'm sure the poor thing is devastated. She's lost a wonderful father.
I mean, people have agreed that it doesn't have... it doesn't have the push some of the other ones have. Like Skyrim and stuff. And there's not as much spontaneous stuff happening as it in say Fallout and Skyrim, where you'd have a mission marker that's on the other side of the map and you'd basically walk towards it, and on your way loads of other weird stuff would happen. You'd be attacked by robots, find some guy fallen down by the side of the road going, help me please, and then there are all these different quest lines and you get distracted, and then you'd find like an abandoned facility, you'd go through the facility and have interesting little stories to tell inside the facility, and eventually you'd get to the damn quest point where you actually did the thing you really just set off to do.
Quiet.
But this game isn't like that. This game very much is, you do just have a checklist and you just go through the quests one at a time, and then you just continuously pick up more, but you don't pick them up by stuff happening generally. It's mostly NPCs just murmuring to each other, and it comes up with a quest in your activity in your damn log just constantly. It's like so the pace, I feel like the pacing is just not the same. That's all it comes down to, but the content's still here. It's still a very long game. It's still lots of stuff to do. Right, this is completely out of your control. I forgot what she said here, but
I really wish I could believe that.
Oh.
Our charter at Constellation has always been to analyze the unknown, but rarely at the expense of our members' lives. Yet all the while, I've been cavalier about taking risks and pushing the boundaries, not appreciating the true cost of my actions.
Is she getting broody again?
Had I not pushed so hard to pursue the Starborn, perhaps none of this would have happened at all and Sam would still be alive.
Ah, right. Right, she's worrying about that. At the expense of our members' lives?
I can't sugarcoat our mission statement. Space travel and planetary exploration is inherently risky. Even Constellation's founder, Sebastian Banks, went missing on an expedition.
Yeah.
This particular danger with the Starborn is off the scale. We truly don't know what we're dealing with.
No, that's true. Sarah Morgan, I know, wouldn't let the Starborn get away with their plan. I'll just...
Light him up!
What the bollocks just happened? What's going on? What's going on? I can't control anything. Things are exploding. Oh, am I being attacked? I think I'm being attacked from behind. Ow! I can't see anything. Sarah's just left me. Sarah, don't leave me. Am I dead? Am I dead? I'm trying to turn the camera. I can turn the camera slightly. Only slightly. Or is it... No, is it just following... I'm about... Oh, am I low health? Am I about to die? Literally can't... Yeah, I'm dead. Bugger! What the bollocks was that? Where did it last save? Damn it all, it was when we came back with Andreas. I've just lost all of that progress, all those conversations. Fuck this. I'm gonna have to redo all of those conversations. I don't even know, Deathwish. Something just came out of nowhere and killed me. I just broke that, didn't I? Oops. I zoomed in at the wrong time. I don't know. Something attacked me from behind and killed me. That was utter shit. What's that now? 88 deaths. 88 deaths. Oh, that was fucking terrible. We're just casually having a conversation and an aggressive monster that I couldn't even see just bit my head off from fucking behind. So the calm... swoons of relaxing jazz. Yeah. I think I'm done. I'm gonna have to redo all of that, and I can't be bothered to have you guys watch that. I can't be bothered to do it now. I want a slice of toast. Is that weird? I want a slice of toast. Cheese on toast or something. What did you have for dinner, Deathwish? Anything good? Marmite. Why Marmite? I don't have any Marmite. I've never really ever eaten much Marmite. I've cooked with it occasionally. Like sometimes I'm doing sauces and stuff and pastas, and it adds an interesting kick to throw in a spoonful of Marmite, but I don't do anything else with it. We had homemade nachos. Ooh, they sound good. And a slice of chocky cake. That sounds extra good. I love chocolate cake. I haven't had any in ages, but I'm very allergic to milk, so. Not so drastically that my brain would melt out of my nose, but it gives me sneezing fits and stuff like that, so I have to stay away from it, really. I think it's the main reason I basically lost my sense of smell. I can't smell no more. You can see, though, that this is my reasoning, because these bugs keep getting in the way as well. This is my reasoning why we're going to wind down a bit on Starfield soon, Deathwish. We've spent over 200 hours of the game playing it. I've still got loads of stuff in it I haven't done that I want to do. There's some ships that I want to build and design, but I haven't been able to level up the building because we've been focusing on all the science on the trees. So... I need to do the ship ones soon, though, because I want to design and make some interesting spaceships. Don't explode at your ass. Well, I'm not having any milk now. Oh, I was talking about cheese. Oh, well, can I have goat's cheese? It's goat's cheese I've got. Goat's cheese I'm allowed because I don't think... Well, I've not seen much evidence that it affects me the same way as cow's milk, so... Which tends to make sense with allergies, because allergies would be to the proteins, the organicness, the proteins contained within the substance, liquid, meat, whatever. Absolutely, yeah, you say lactose, but lactose isn't organic specifically. Lactose is, you know, it's made by organics, but lactose is just the sugar. So, I tried lacto-free cow milk once, but it still made me ill. So it makes more sense, because when people have lactose intolerance, that's more that they can't digest the lactose. Their bodies can't break down the sugars. Because you need certain foods require certain, what's the word? Protein? No, microbes. Yes, certain microbes or I guess it would be amino acids to break them down. And if your body runs out of it, then you end up having an issue. That's why lactose intolerance is so common generally with the human race at the moment. And I gather in particular in Asians. You could say that's, if you really wanted to, you could say that was racist, but it's not racist if it's a statistic. So, it just is a biology lesson from Dr. Wilson. I am by no means an expert on the matter, but there's things that I have learned. Like, there's things I do, like, there's things I just generally remember. Like, I did study, when I did mineralogy, industrial minerals, that was the particular one, at university. Like I had to do a presentation as well, but I ended up writing a paper on asbestos. So I remember an awful lot of stuff about asbestos. That's public perception of it is quite different to what it actually, you know, the issues actually are. Fear mongering and all that. But yeah, no, there's little things. But this is, yeah, we're gonna change things up soon, Deathwish. We're gonna play some different games. We're gonna check out all. Something's gone wrong with me green screen. I didn't even see it was at a... I must have messed with the camera by mistake earlier. Oops. Yeah, we're gonna start playing some of the games again. Now, what games? I haven't the foggiest idea, really. Spider-Man 2. Exactly. See, Spider-Man 2's coming out. I'd like to play that. This is the... Because I was focusing on Starfield because I knew I'd enjoy playing Starfield, and I have. But it is... I think I am finding it a little bit exhausting now. It's not, and I don't know if it's the game itself or whether I've stuck to only one game for basically a month now for stream. And well, that was quite different to how we ran things for the last year and a half, wasn't it? So yeah, so I feel like we want to change it up a bit. What to go into though? Again, yeah, like I said, no idea. And they still have loads of my backlog I want to do. I made an entire overlay, actually, for One Piece, because there was the One Piece RPG coming out, and I wanted to do that. I mean, we haven't... I want to go back on Final Fantasies. They're going to be bringing out the next one of them soon. The 7 Remake Part 2. As well as the next expansion for Final Fantasy Online, so part of me wants to get back on Final Fantasy. I haven't touched my Switch... likely in a year, so I haven't been anywhere near the new Zelda or Metroid. And there's the new Mario coming out. Is it next week? I think the new Mario Wonder game's out next week, and that looks quite entertaining, because it's like a really, it looks like they've gone all out on this one. It's really trippy and weird, and characters turn into elephants and shit. So I'd like to give that a go. Does anyone have anything they're looking forward to, want to share with the class? You're buying a Switch OLED for your son, but I also might want to use it. Well, yeah, there's plenty of good games on Switch. I would usually still say that it's mostly the Nintendo. It's like I'd never recommend anyone to say, you know, buy a Switch to play the Assassin's Creed games. Like, it's just a no, isn't it? You wouldn't do that. The Nintendo particular games, the Switch exclusive games, are the ones that are worth having on a Switch. Anything else, if it's not a Switch exclusive, it's not worth having. It's not worth including. I've got a little list here, actually. I wonder if I can share it quick. Of, like, the stuff that's come to Game Pass. Because that always is a good... yeah, that's the one, but I'm on the wrong screen. There you go. There's... I always like using this... Because we used to do a What's New Wilson Tuesday stream where we went through all the new stuff on Games Pass. He wants Mario 3D World and you want Mario Wonder. An RPG. Oh, yeah, because they're doing the sort of... I guess it's a remake of the original Mario RPG. As well as they're porting over the GameCube's Paper Mario and the Thousand Year Door, which is probably one of my favorite all-time RPGs ever. Turn-based RPGs, it's a fantastic game. And I had it on GameCube, still do technically, but the disc's no longer in the box, disappeared. We have no idea where it's gone. So it's always been a massive pain point to me that we couldn't play any more Thousand Year Door Paper Mario because it was so good, so flipping good. But yeah, this is their list here of stuff coming out on Games Pass. I mean, this month alone has had some interesting stuff. Cocoon, I hear, is a very cool puzzle game. Lies of P, of course, has been out. They brought over Party Animals and Phoenix Wright. So some interesting titles if you're into that kind of thing. Gotham Knights, which is reminiscent, I guess, of Arkham. The Arkham Asylum games, but I don't think I'd be bothered to play that nowadays. I think Lamplighters League was a strategy game. Warhammer 40,000, is that the FPS? Warhammer 1, yeah. The Nature's Forza Motorsport, I think I looked at From Space. It looked like some sort of strange indie top-down thing. Adam says, I'm halfway through Cocoon. Really fun little game. Yeah, it sounds like quite interesting. I didn't read too much into it, but I did spot an article that said they specified that apparently the simplest puzzle in the game was actually the hardest one to make. I was like, wow, how does that even happen? How does that make sense? And then there's a bunch more. You got Like a Dragon. So you got the next Dragon game out. So this one's a beat 'em up again instead of the turn-based, like the last one. But then there will be a follow-up to the turn-based one, which is, I think it's Infinite Wealth that will be coming out beginning of next year. I think it's beginning of next year. It's not listed on here. They've done quite well with the Dragon games, haven't they? Yakuza games. On Games Pass. City Skylines is coming out on my birthday. Frog Detective. No idea what that is. Minako's Night Market. Oh, looks like a cute little indie. Yeah. Headbangers Rhythm Royale. What makes it headbanging? Some sort of music rhythm game. Okay. And Jusant. Ooh. Oh, is this sort of really interesting climbing one? I feel like I do recall it. Though I can't remember any particulars. But that's October for you. That's October straight away. I mean, look, you've even got Persona 5 Tactica coming out. Oh, and there's another Dragon one. Oh, hang on, there's two then. Oh, wait, so is that the one I was thinking of? Wait, hang on, so which one is Ishin again? Oh, is that the old school Japanese one? Ah, okay, they're both hack and slashy ones. But yeah, that's the old period piece one. Don't know why I confused the two. Yeah. So I think I do like need to bring back our What's New day where we try out all the new games on PlayStation Plus and Games Pass and whatever other free things we can try out. But I also want to do ones where we can play games together again. You guys can play games with me. I mean, that's why I was trying to decide for tomorrow. See, it's going to be the last day I stream for a week. I'm taking a week off to go to visit me gran. I haven't seen her in a while, so I'm going to go visit me granny. She's my last grandparent still alive. So I'm gonna go and hang out with her and listen to some of her interesting stories. She has good ones. I do like listening to them. It's also quite chill hanging out with her. But that's why tomorrow was like gonna be my last stream for a week. Then I thought maybe we do something different than just do Starfield. Now I have for a while wanted to play with you all because you can all play it as well. It is free. It's a free game. That is that they have recently, September, wasn't it? So last month, they finally brought Disney Speedstorm. So the Mario Kart with Disney characters has come out now on all consoles. It's free to play and it's cross-play. So we could technically do hosted games on stream. We could all race each other with Lilo and Stitch, Mickey Mouse, whatever, you know, all of them. They've not added in everything yet, but that's the one good thing that I've enjoyed about the game is that they're not skimp, as a live service games go, it's the only one I've ever found that isn't really shitty about its updates. It adds every 6 weeks, they do a new update that adds in new races. I mean, that's, and tracks, that's it. That's all they need. And then you just get a bunch of challenges that you just do as and when you want to. There's none of this, oh, you need to play every single day or you lose out on stuff. I mean, there is a bonus if you play every day, but it's not like it's much. You just get some extra coins. That's what I mean. It's not one of these that tries to use fear of missing out as much as some of the other games have, because you can still get the... Like, if you don't take part in the newest events and get the races, yeah, you'd maybe take a bit longer to get them, but you can still get them all. So it's not like it's... You're not. It doesn't it doesn't skewer you for not playing. That's the term I'm looking for. Yeah. So I thought that would be interesting to do. Yeah. I mean, I think I've streamed it once before as a request, but it was during the time when you had to buy early access, so people weren't interested, you know, that much. I feel like we could do some more stuff out of it. But that was one of the ones I wanted to do. And then, yeah, we'll bring back the game request days where you guys can request what games I play. I mean, I technically still have the button right now, but there's not much point putting it on because we're not going to be using it this week. We could do when we get back, but I'm trying to decide the plans for getting back because it's Halloween. When I get back, it's going to be basically Halloween week. Because I'll be away this coming week from the 16th to the 20th. So tomorrow's stream will be the last stream until the 23rd, and then we'll be the week before Halloween, leading up to Halloween. So we're going to do some Halloween stuff. That's why I'm probably going to scale back Starfield, so we can at least do some of that. Horror streams, exactly, Deathwish. Now, what games to pick? What games to pick is very hard. It's a very hard decision. What I was hoping I'd do is on my birthday, we'll all check out Alan Wake 2. But unfortunately, I forgot that it doesn't come out until the 27th. So it's after my birthday. Anything that makes you poo your pants? Well, I've never found any horror games that actually scare me. I mean, I guess the scariest game I've ever played, off the top of my head, the PT demo was pretty frightening. PT demo was horrendous. But thinking about it, I mean, I guess the only one generally I found quite scary was Dead Space 2, because it did have an awful lot of jump scares, and there was that one scene where he like sticks a needle in the guy's eye, and I've always had a massive thing about needles. I'm better nowadays. After COVID and having to have all those shots, I'm kind of used to needles now. I had to have them. There weren't any way around it, so you wouldn't be allowed out your house unless you had them. So very much had to go and get them. I've been trying to put together a list. And does anyone have anything else they've been looking forward to coming out horror-wise, or do they have a favorite horror game from the past? I haven't played Dead by Daylight in a very long time, and I did find it funny they were adding Nicolas Cage into that. Just as you do, just add in Nicolas Cage. let's switch to my chatting channel. I don't think we need to be on this one anymore. Let's switch over to the channel. That happened at the same time. That was quite surprising. I know someone who refused the vaccines and got fired. Really? That's dick. That's a dick thing to do. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I can imagine saying, you know, you have to stay at home or whatever. But most people could Well, apart from if it's a physical job, I guess. Most people could work from home and it not matter as much. So it's a little surprising that that happened. I feel sorry for them. I hope they found a new job, Deathwish. I hope they did, because that's crap for that to happen. Ugh. I mean, we could have a blast from a blast. We could go back and check out some of the old Alan Wakes. Because I have them digital. I have them digital on my 360. Therefore, I have access to Alan Wake 1 and Alan Wake American Nightmare. So we could always check out those again. I know they've added a Halloween-themed DLC to High on Life, which is another spacey game that I've always wanted to play. I have an entire overlay that I've designed specifically for playing Squanch games like High on Life. And again, we've never used that overlay because I've never played those games. Yeah. One day we'll get around to it. Yes, they did. Yes. Yeah, High on Knife. Where's Ayn? He's probably downstairs. He usually hangs out with my brother when my brother's here, so he doesn't really come upstairs much. I can shout him, but I doubt he'll come in. I doubt he'll come up to us. I mute myself so you don't have to listen to me shout. No, no response. He doesn't sometimes. He just doesn't. He's hiding somewhere beyond the veil. Yeah. Over that ridge over there. Just behind that frozen ridge. That's where Ayn's hiding. Looking for snacks. In his little doggy spacesuit. Actually, I guess when I'm on these planet locations, I probably should have like a spacesuit on me, shouldn't I? Should automatically add a little spacesuit helmet so that I can, you know, breathe oxygen. Yeah. Oh dear. What noise? He possibly to responds. As in, what noise does he respond to? Well, I just say his name and then he tends to come. Or I say snackos. I got this little bowl that I always keep on here that's just full of his kibble. Not much, because he ate a lot of it the other day. And I just go, Ayn, treetos. But he sometimes decides, I think he knows when I'm streaming. I think he knows when I'm streaming, and he doesn't actually want to come in my room when I'm streaming, because he knows that I probably won't play with him as much. So, because if I'm not streaming, he will be either begging me for food or my brother, who'll be lying on our chest. And that's the thing, my brother isn't streaming, so my brother will be downstairs, so he'll be bothering my brother. He'll probably be sitting on my brother, half watching the telly with my brother. He doesn't really watch the telly. He only pays attention to the telly. You know when he's noticed the telly, because he will immediately jump up at it. He'll be hopping up and down, and he'll be screaming, and he'll be barking. Then you'll be like, what are you barking at, Ayn? And he'll be like, oh, he saw a sheep. Oh, he saw a horse. It's not just dogs. Immediately, I don't know if he's barked at cats on it before. I can't quite recall if the last time I saw a cat on the telly. Sometimes it can be sometimes it could be a dude with a very large hair. It's just, if there's anything I'm hearing on the screen that looks like it's fluffy, he will be barking at it. No other reason. Hiya. Okay. But right, yeah, I'm gonna do this. Spend this week off putting together some plans and coming up with some more Halloween stuff. We've been trying to put together some Halloween games for you and all. Because I will be taking... I'm not streaming all day on my birthday, but I think we're going to do a Halloween stream day. Or at least a longer stream. Yeah, we're going to be doing a longer stream event for Halloween on the final day of the month. And my housemate has shoehorned me into agreeing that he is allowed to prepare us some trick-or-treat profiteroles. So look forward to that, guys, because you're gonna get the chance to feed me disgusting and weird things. And maybe some nice things. Is Fluff got cuts? Sad. Is Fluff from Ayn? I mean, I do have to... I don't shear my dog. That's not how it works. But he does have a defluffer. Because basically, the corgis, they have like an underlayer of white hair above his, you know, nice little golden red hair. And I have to basically continuously pull out all this white fluff. It's an awful lot of it. Like, a lot. Dog hair in my house is everywhere. You could probably one on me now. There's a dog hair. There's a dog hair. Dog hair's everywhere. You just get everywhere. Luckily not in the food. Luckily not in the food, but it would be terrible if they did that. Oh look, somebody's trying to spam me with more. Sorry for bothering you, I want you to give me money. No, Rushing. That's obviously a fake name and all. Rushing Chalek. I will not give you money, go away. Drop Ein Vlog someday on YouTube. I mean, did I do a YouTube thing for when we gave him his birthday? We did him a birthday party last year. Ein's birthday's January. So we had a birthday party for Ein last January and we gave him I gave him a cheeseburger live. So I think there's a clip of that on YouTube. It was quite good. We'll do it again this year, shall we? We should give him another cheeseburger. I decided that before I ever started streaming, I decided I'd give Ian a cheeseburger on his birthday every year. Because they're allowed to have cheeseburgers if you make it plain. Brown bread. They can have the lettuce, they can have the tomato. There's nothing in it they technically can't eat. It's just maybe a little bit fatty. So it's not an everyday thing, but once in a blue moon thing, yeah, he can have a cheeseburger. And believe me, he very much enjoyed that cheeseburger. He was all so we know he enjoyed it. Right, we're gonna wrap this up. We're gonna go raid somebody else. We're gonna take this party somewhere. Oh, dude, there's some interesting people on this evening. I feel like we've got an interesting choice to make of who we're gonna raid. But first, we must have a fight. This is a very strange song that's just suddenly come up. Is this jazz? Apparently it's jazz. No, it's pop. Why is there pop music in the jazz playlist? I don't understand why this keeps happening, but whatever.
Choose your fighter.
It's time to fight, yes. Raids my friend. Oh, you want me to raid your friend, Xion? I wanted to raid my friend. That's fine, we can do that. Someone called Jazz. Jazz? So you know who Xion's friend is as well, Adam? Or do you mean you have a recommendation to raid? If you have a recommendation to raid, guys, throw them in chat. Yeah, yeah. Before that, we're going to have a fight. If you haven't done so, say something in chat. Your avatar will spawn below. And then we'll proceed to the battle floor. I'll give you 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's do this. I was joking about the music. Oh, from jazz to jazz. Like the name jazz.
Three,
yeah.
2, 1, go!
Oh, see, and this reminds me about all the levels that I haven't finished making. But I did manage to do this Minecraft one, so I'm proud of that. But I need to sit and finish sorting out all the levels. Because I was only half done. And there's all these tracks that I want to add as well. We'll get there. We'll get there one day. Yeah. Sid's down! Bum, 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 bum. Adam's hanging on just barely. I think that was you, Deathwish. And I'm out. Let's see if you can get a sneaky back attack in, Adam. Sneaky back attack him. Oh, you've avoided that. Oh no, Xion's coming for you, Adam. Watch out. That was serious. That was a serious death fight there. Yeah. Well, it looks more like they ganged up on you, but still. Oh, Xion's out. That's it. It's Veos. Veos is the winner. Good job, Veos. Veos won.
Game.
And it ends just in time for you to see the skeleton burst into flames in the background. All right. I mean, who I was going to suggest is that we got raided the other day by Snorbuckle. So Snorbuckle's on. We could raid him. Or there is Rome Boy, who is also on. Who is, well, funnily enough, they're both, like, he's normally on really late, so I can't normally raid him. He's on too late. But they're actually both on. They're both playing Bloodborne. Snorbuckle's playing Bloodborne for the first time, and Rome Boy is trying to beat Bloodborne without leveling at all. Well, Xion would like us to raid Bakunian Nick. Well, I'll put him in. I'll have a look. See what he's up to. He's doing marbles on stream. What language does he speak, though? I can't raid someone that doesn't speak English. He's not saying anything. He's not saying anything. He's so gentleman. Well, I, yeah, we haven't had a new recommendation for a while, so he's doing marbles on stream, which I've never, admittedly, that's another one I've never tried. We could give that a go someday, though I don't really know. Because what was there? There's marbles on stream that people like playing, and there's also the ducks one. I've seen those two. They're quite popular. Kind of like, I feel like I'd like to have a go with both of those one day. Should be possible. Okay, all right, marbles. Shall we see if we go join him on a marbles run? Let's see. Arcanian Nick. Invalid username. Oh, okay, that's not worked. Oh, right! It's got an underscore in it. It's got an underscore, so it won't work unless I add that. Oh, before we do it, though, before we do it, one last thing. I think I have now fully upgraded the Nyan Cat, so it should work with all the different songs. No one's redeemed it today, so I'm going to do a redeem. We're going to check. We're going to check that Nyan Cat is working with all the new layers. Are there still a few things I'd like to tweak to it? Oh, no. Oh, you beat me. Okay, that did work. It did work. Though we didn't get a different song. It's basically designed now that it can play different songs. Variations of the Nyan Cat song. I still have to sing along regardless. But yeah. Okay. Let's summon Nick. Raid has been created. Perfect. Okay. Come one and all and give a big hearty hoo-ha. Wilson. Yeah. I still haven't made a button. Don't know why I keep forgetting. Raid. To Mr. Mancunian Nick, who's enjoying some stream marbles. Okay. I will indeed see you all then tomorrow for another episode of Slightly Wilson Show. We're gonna have a bit of banter tomorrow. We're gonna speed finish the Sol system by doing Pluto and its moon. And then we'll have a quick discussion again around what we're looking forward to this Halloween, what horror films you might be planning to watch. Till then, guys, hope you have a good evening, sleep well, and as always, folks, don't touch those dials.